Tonight, we are hearing the 911 call made from the ex-boyfriend of tennis star Jennifer Capriati after he says she attacked him. Good evening. I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Todd McDermott. Thanks for joining us. Angela Rozier joins us with this WPBF 25 News exclusive. Angela?
Todd and Tiffany, that incident report we received from the police department states that call was made while he was hiding in a locked men's locker room. Now, Jennifer Capriati is used to making headlines on the tennis court, but now she's swinging back via Twitter.
911, where is your emergency?
Yes.
Okay, what's the problem? Okay.
Assaulted.
Jennifer Capriati denies she did anything wrong. She's been tweeting followers all day. I'm waiting for Ashton Kutcher to jump out at me and say, you've been punked. LOL, Ashton, where are you? According to this incident report with the North Palm Beach Police Department, her ex-boyfriend, Ivan Brennan, filed a complaint accusing Capriati of attacking him at a local gym on Valentine's Day. The report states, while he was working out, Capriati entered the gym, walked up to him, and started screaming, harassing him. The report also states, as the incident escalated, Capriati punched Brennan with a closed fist 4 times in the chest. Brennan was able to escape from Capriati, locked himself in the men's locker room, and called police.
And what exactly did she do, and how did this kind of happen?
She pushed me 3 times, trying to get in the men's locker room, and she first put her finger in my chest, pushed me 3 times, and then hit me in the chest.
But Capriati is firing back. All of this is absurd. I'm outraged by the media, by my ex, the false accusations, and not being able to say the truth. Well, police here in North Palm Beach investigated this case, but they say it's since been turned over to the state attorney's office. We reached out to Capriati for an on-camera interview, but a spokeswoman told us she would not be talking at this time. But she did release this statement. We will make sure that Ms. Capriati's side of the story is fully conveyed. And when the truth comes out, she will be vindicated from these charges.
And police tell us no warrant was actually issued in this case. As a matter of fact, we also tried to reach out to Brennan, but no one returned our phone call. Now, coming up at 6, we'll hear more from the 911 dates. Reporting live in the newsroom, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.